top of my speech is a new paradigm we use at the University of Messina regarding the treatment of arteriovenous malformation in terms of revisitation of the concept of eloquence. We all know from the past that in 1986, Spetzer and Martin proposed this monumental work that belongs to the scenario of every neurosurgical department worldwide, where they for the first time categorized arteriovenous malformation in terms of size of venous drainage and the eloquence. And again, these authors in 2011 or reorganized their classification of arteriovenous malformation in this three-tier system applied to about 1,500 of patients from seven surgical series, categorized according to the Spetzer and Martin grades, proposing through this classification a possible treatment in terms of resection of multimodal treatment or no treatment at all for the most serious cases. However, in these 30 years, things have changed, and what was emerging in 1986 as a novelty and a monumental work in some way may be rediscussed today in the light of the modern acquisition we have in terms of brain knowledge, in terms of the new paradigms we consider the brain function. So let's go step again to the three pillars of the Spetzer and Martin classification. First of all is size, but size cannot be changed by time. And again, size in this case has a sense and does matter. In terms of venous drainage, that belongs to the characteristics of the single patient of the single AVM. But what is the matter of discussion in the light of the new acquisition is the concept of eloquence. Blaise Pascal considered the terms of eloquence, described it as a painting of thoughts that probably means nothing. But for we neurosurgeon, eloquence is something that is serious. And we think about eloquence of the area for every single case we treat. Again, in 1986, eloquence was located in the sensory motor areas, in the language areas, in the primary visual area, and in the deep structures, assuming that the eloquent cortical region occupied the normal location, which cannot be true in every single case, as the presence of hematoma may spread away a function or a location, or the recategorization of this area now with the modern MRI and the new tools we have has changed. And what made a shift in this paradigm is the moving from pamphlet to topography to the odotopy. The concept of odotopy introduced for the first time by Hugh Dufaux in terms for the brain tumors, exploring as the new sense of the connectome and the networks that exist below and far away from the simple homunculus of the 30s. And now the eloquence may be redesigned. We have tons of options in our surgical fields, even in Belgrade, in Messina, or in the US, or in Brazil, as the previous speakers, where we reassess with different tools what eloquence could be, and how we consider these in our own made characteristics. We at the University of Messina have a long history of experience in navigated transcranial magnetic stimulation. Is a tool that allowed us to redesign the concept of eloquence of single brain area, and we use for stimulate preoperatively with a neurophysiological mapping prior to any kind of brain procedure. This is a simple an example where we stimulate the cortex of a patient, segmenting the motor function for the arm, for the face, or for the leg, trying to explore the region around the lesion and allowing us to separate for the corticospinal tract the single area and the single fibers for leg, for arm, for face. And these experiences have been moved to the language functions, to the visual motor activities, and to other neurological functions that again may represent the new sense of eloquence. Since the last 8 years, we've applied this technique in more than 200 patients, assessing glioma, meningiomas, cavernous angioma, Mets, and AVM. And in 15 cases during the last 4 years, from 2017 to 2011, we have assessed the new concept of eloquence and published this data in World Neurosurgery. I did a Medline search a few days ago, 2 days actually, and only 7 results exist in the literature assessing the NTMS and the arterial venous malformation, made mostly by friends like Krieg and Peter Vajkowski. I want to show you through a few cases what is the sense of this discussion. Look at this little AVM that is located very close to the motor area. We may consider this a Vrolandic AVM in an eloquent area. Size is 1, eloquence is 1, venous drainage is 0. We would categorize this AVM in terms of 2. And so we should propose a surgical treatment to the patient considering the risk of the Vrolandic area. However, the NTMS shows us that the true position of the Vrolandic area is in front, considering the location of the nidus, which now is not in the Vrolandic, but it is post-Vrolandic. So allowing us for an easier surgery and a better presentation to the cases, and considering it definitely as a candidate for surgery and not for other modalities of treatment. Here is the stunt reconstruction that we did in these cases. The new angiography. Again, size is 1, drainage is 0, eloquence is 1. We will consider it as a Spetzler and Martin grade 2 AVM. Now with the new assessment of the AVM, of the eloquence, we will consider it as a Spetzler Martin grade 1 AVM. So the patient has been treated. This is the postoperative MRI, and as you can see, no postoperative motor deficits appeared. Why I may expect a postoperative deficit in this patient? This is not the sense of the presentation. The sense of the presentation is that the paradigm for the choice of treatment in these specific cases may change, considering the new revisitation of the eloquence. This paradigm has been exported also in more complicated cases, and for the every case that we have treated in these years. Look at this pre-Rolandic AVM, 2 in size, 1 in venous drainage, 0 in eloquence. Here is the Rolandic fissure. However, although this is the angiography, reconstructing the Rolandic nidus and the NTMS-based reconstruction of the corticospinal fibers, we may now consider that this simple AVM is a high-risk AVM for treatment because of possible motor deficits. Path of the corticospinal tract below the AVM and not in front. So paying attention to these cases that was considered initially a Spetzler-Martin grade 3, we considered to surgery. And now it's changing in 4 because the eloquence now is yes because of the fibers. And we propose to this patient multimodal treatment, embolization and then surgery. Here is a short video. Standard surgery as for every single center. We are in the interhemispheric fissure is here. Cortical superficial assessment of the motor area. So for the confirmation of the NTMS data, intraoperative angiography, funding the AVM in terms of feeders, and then separation and preparation of the single feeders, coagulation, cutting, clipping when necessary with aneurysmus clips, and the nidus is here below the cortex in the interhemispheric frontal area, easily finding of the feeders, coagulation, vessel and passage, removal of the nidus, at the end the veins, the AVM is totally devascularized, and remove it. Intraoperative check allowed us to spare the corticospinal tract. This is the pre and post angiography. The patient is still walking on ward. She's doing fine on second postoperative dates. Some AVM may present as atypical, like this, where the possibility was of damage was not because of the motor tract, but because of the language area. Another case with postrolandic AVM. Surgery again, pre and postoperative day, and no deficits in these cases. Let me go to the conclusion. This multimodal protocol we adopted at the University of Messina allowed us to include not only the DTI fiber tracking and the 3D angiography reconstruction, but the cortical mapping and the subcortical mapping already known in the preoperative planning we use for every single case of AVM. So the model treatment included another step that combines and allow us to find out the best solution for every single case. And through this intraoperative surgical guidance, we have been able to obtain a significant better outcome of the patient treated at our department. Again, thank you, Lucas. Congratulations for the event, and thanks for the time you dedicated to me.